Good morning, children. Today, again, we are going to carry our chapter, chapter 1, crop production and management. The part which we are going to study today is weeding till storage. We are going to start from weeding and we are going to study till storage in this video. Okay, the next topic is weeding. As the name, it's weed. Weed means unwanted plants. So, when we grow crops, a huge number of unwanted plants also grow and we call them as weeds. These weeds, they are harmful for the growth of crops. Because, why they are harmful? Because they compete with them for the requirement of nutrients, water, sunlight, oxygen and everything. Okay, now suppose a person is having one plate of food with him. He is having one apple, one banana and a glass of milk. Another fellow comes and he takes his banana. He says, okay, give me something to eat. He'll give his half of banana, half of milk, half of apple. So what happened? The nutrients are being divided among two, isn't it? Similarly, in the weeds also, same thing happens. Now, this doesn't mean that you should not share your food with others. Okay? I'm just giving you one example just to let you know what actually happens with the weeds when they're grown with the crop plants. Okay? So now, what you have to learn is, first of all, the definition. What is weeds? Then, why they are being removed from the field? The answer is because they are harmful for the growth of crops. Number 2 point, they compete. What they compete? They compete with the nutrients, water and sunlight. Okay. Now, another very important question comes is, name the common weeds. So, the common weeds are, number 1, very easy, grass. Number 2 is Amaranthus, Cholai. Number 3 is Cynopodium, Bathua. Bathu, you must have eaten up over there, Bathu. And then wild oats. We don't eat wild oats, okay? So, these are the ones which grow in the fields along with the main crops. Hence, we are supposed to remove them timely, okay? Now, weeds can be removed either by hand or by using weedicides. Another question comes over here, name some weedicides. So, 2,4-D, then isoproturon, simazine, metachlor, butachlor and MCPA. Okay. So, you can learn these also. Like 2,4-DA, butachlor is eating, isn't it? So, you make a line and then you can learn it again. If you want the tricks to learn, I'll be sending you. So, weedicides, how are they used better? They are sprayed to destroy those weeds which are very poisonous for the crop plants. That is why it is necessary to wash the crops before using them as a food. They also destroy useful microorganisms present in the soil. Can you name a microorganism which is useful? Yes, very good children. It's earthworm. Therefore, weedicides should be used with wise discretion only. This means wisely. If it is very, very necessary, only then use weedicides. Otherwise, use your hands to remove the weeds from the main crops. Now, they can also be removed. When you are removing by hand, what are the things you need? It is, one is trowel, another is harrow. Okay, so instrument which are used to remove weeds, they are trowel and harrow. Clear to you? Okay. Another one is, the next topic is crop protection. Now, what is crop protection? We have irrigated the crops. We have removed the weeds. Now, crop is very nice, isn't it? Yeah, big fruits are there coming over there. Then what you see? You see that pests are coming and eating, birds are coming and eating, then animals are coming, then rats are coming. So many things are there. What are they doing? They are destroying your crops. So what do we need? We need crop protection. So various pests which destroy crops an organism which destroys the crops. It is called as a pest. These pests may be virus, bacteria and fungi, microorganisms, beta, which cause several diseases in plants. The small animals such as insects, rats, mites, birds, they also attack crops and destroy them. Then there are big animals also that do a great harm to the farmers. Big animals like donkeys, isn't it? Cows, dogs, buffaloes, they, pigs, they go on running over inside the field, isn't it? And then they are destroying the crops. Very good. Now, how can you control these pests? Number one, these pests can be controlled biologically by introducing some birds. Now, what does this mean, word biologically? Insects deliberately into the field to kill the pest. Now, you see, there are particular types of pests that birds eat. So bring some birds, introduce some birds that are able to eat these pests. It is called as biological controlling of pest. Okay, clear. Then another method is chemicals. They are used to kill the pest. They are called as pesticides. Then again, learn the name. DDT, malathion, BHC, sulfur and warfarin. Warfarin. All the pesticides are best effective to control the pest. Again, they can kill both, as earlier we have studied, useful as well as harmful organisms. Therefore, a good pesticide should be biodegradable. Very important. Selective in use and affordable. It means biodegradable means it should not remain in the soil. Rather, it should be decomposed and it should be finished up inside the soil. Okay. Then selective in use means you should not go on using it blindly. You use huge amount of pesticides. No, it's again harmful for the crops. Affordable means it should not be very, very costly. It should be little cheaper. Then another method is fencing. Just fence the fields. So all the stray animals, dog, cows and all those donkeys, etc., they are not going to enter the field. Now in many places, a sugar cane is kept in a standing position to scare away birds. One more thing, what that is scarecrow. They haven't mentioned that name over here. Scarecrow, that means we put up a big bamboo stick in the field with a cross bamboo stick, and then we put a human clothes on it with a pot over it. Then on the pot, that turban is kept over on the pot, some cloth is there. So the birds are, what that is called, it is called scarecrow, and the birds get scared and then they don't attack the crops. Then now you have saved your crops also. Now comes the time to harvest. It takes about 3 to 4 months for a crop to mature. Okay. The mature crop is ready to cut and gather in heaps. So the process of cutting and gathering of mature crop is called harvesting. So what is harvesting? Process of cutting the crops, gathering them, is called as harvesting. Now the very, very important, a sickle. What is sickle? Sickle is an instrument used to cut the crop at a height that is close to the surface of the soil. That means we cut the crop near the ground. Combine is another machine that is used for harvesting and threshing. Now what is threshing, beta? Threshing is removal of grains from the crop plant. Okay, so after harvesting, grains are beaten out from the crop. This process is called threshing. So grains, separating the grains from the crop, the process is called as threshing. It can be done manually. It can be done using oxen or buffalo stepped up over the crops. A thresher machine called combine is also used for harvesting and threshing. Harvesting means they cut the crop and then they remove the grains and we get the crop in the grain form. Got it? Then comes the winnowing. You have studied in 6th standard winnowing. I hope you remember. Okay, good. The grains separated after threshing need to remove chaff from them. What is a chaff? C-H-A-F-F? Yes, the outer cover of the seed. the outer cover of the grains like wheat and rice. That is chaff. So it's a, now what principle is used over here? Do you remember? The principle used is that the actual grain is heavier as compared to the chaff. That is why when we throw it from a huge height from the ground, what happens? The grain falls just beneath and the chaff falls away little by away. Why? Because of the air which blows it away due to its less weight. Now, farmers take the mixture of grains and chaff and allow it to fall gently from a height on the ground. The chaff, being lighter, blows away with the wind. The heavier grains fall straight on the ground and are separated. Now, you got the grains, children? Yes. Now comes the turn of storage. Storage means grains need to be dried before storage as they contain more moisture. After drying, grains are packed in gunny bags or jute bags and they are stored in godowns. The stored grains in godown also need to be protected from animals and humidity. Now see, so much important thing is there. Now, so we have worked so hard in growing the crops. We got the grains, so bumper harvest is there. Now suppose you don't take care after this, then our whole hard work will be wasted. So please don't do that. Number one point is check the moisture content. Because at the time of harvesting, the moisture content is the maximum. So you have to dry it in the sun. When you dry it, then we are going to pack up in the gunny bags. They are being packed up so that the air doesn't enter it. And then they are stored in godowns. Big, big godowns are there. Why? So that animals do not attack them. Do not go on punching over them. Okay. Also, it is saved from rain. If rain comes, what will happen? It will be wet. That means more humidity, more wetness, more water content will increase fungus, microorganisms, and hence it will be damaged. Okay. So, humidity means water content. So, moisture, what does moisture do? It promotes the growth of fungi on the grains. Rats also damage grains in godowns. Okay. So, some grains are needed to be stored for future use. And this stored stock is known as buffer stock. So, buffer stock means huge stock which you store for the future use is called as a buffer stock. Like some types of fruits are there, vegetables are there. They are kept in cold storage to prevent them from spoiling. So, children, till now what we have done in crop production? First of all, we studied about what agriculture is. Then how man came to the process of agriculture. Then we studied about requirements for the agriculture. Then we studied about farming practices like soil preparation. Then what comes under soil preparation? Plowing is there. Leveling is there. Manuring is there. Then we studied about sowing of seeds through broadcasting, seed drill and transplantation. And then followed by the irrigation process. Again, we studied irrigation in detail. Furrow irrigation, basin irrigation, sprinkler irrigation. Then we studied about weeding, the names of weeds, the name of weedicides. Followed by the crop protection from pest and other factors that would destroy the crop. And then we went for the harvesting also. Now in harvesting, we studied how we can harvest using a sickle and a machine. And then we studied about threshing, that is removing of grains. And in the after removing the grains from the crop plant, we studied about winnowing, that is removing of the chaff also. And then the very important step was the storage step, in which we studied about godowns, the buffer stock, and why we are going to store the food for the future use. Very good. Okay. So children, till now we have covered up to storage.
rest of the part of this chapter we are going to have in the next video, and after the completion of the video I'll be giving you the notes. You can make up your notes copy also, the test also, MCQs also. Each and everything of this question will be given, which are suspected to come in the examination. So to stay connected, please subscribe this channel so that you can get the next video as soon as it is uploaded by me. So eat healthy, stay healthy. Bye-bye.